the Stony Tunguska River. It is an eastern tributary of the Yenisei and has a length of 1,160 miles, 1,870 kilometers. The name of the river comes from the fact that it flows under pebble fields without open water. As early as 1610, Russians from Mangazia had passed the Stony Tunguska's confluence with the Yenisei. By the 1620s, Mangazia Cossacks and trappers had ascended it seeking fur tribute from the local Tunguska clans. The Tunguska event in June 1908 occurred near this river, some 8 kilometers, 5.0 miles, SSE of Lake Chico. In its upper reaches, the river is known as Katanga. Its valley forms the northern boundary of the Yenisei Range, north of which rises the Tunguska Plateau. What really happened in Tunguska? On the 30th of June 1908, an explosion ripped through the air above a remote forest in Siberia, near the Podkamenaya, Tunguska River. The fireball is believed to have been 50-100 meter wide. It depleted 2,000 square kilometers of the taiga forest in the area, flattening about 80 million trees. If a meteor survives to hit the ground, it's called a meteorite. The Tunguska object was an estimated 130 feet, 40 meters, in diameter, similar to the size of the unrelated asteroid 2012, DA14, that will come about 17,200 miles, 27,700 kilometers, from Earth, at 2:24 p.m. Tunguska event. The Tunguska event was a large explosion that occurred near the Podkamenaya Tunguska River in Yeniseisk Governorate, Russia, on the morning of the 30th of June 1908. The explosion over the sparsely populated eastern Siberian taiga flattened an estimated 80 million trees over an area of 2,150 km2, 830 square miles, of forest, and eyewitness reports suggest that at least 3 people may have died in the event. The explosion is generally attributed to the airburst of a meteoroid. It is classified as an impact event, even though no impact crater has been found. The object is thought to have disintegrated at an altitude of 5 to 10 kilometers, 3 to 6 miles, rather than to have hit the surface of the Earth. Due to the remoteness of the site and the limited instrumentation available at the time of the event, modern scientific interpretations of its cause and magnitude have relied chiefly on damage assessments and geological studies conducted many years after the fact. Studies have yielded different estimates of the meteoroid size on the order of 50 to 190 meters, 160 to 620 feet, depending on whether the body entered with a low or high speed. It is estimated that the shock wave from the airburst would have measured 5.0 on the Richter magnitude scale, and estimates of its energy have ranged from 3 to 30 megatons of TNT. Nazca Lines. The Nazca Lines are a group of very large geoglyphs formed by depressions or shallow incisions made in the soil of the Nazca Desert in southern Peru. They were created between 500 BCE and 500 CE. Most lines run straight across the landscape, but there are also figurative designs of animals and plants made up of lines. The individual figurative geoglyph designs measure between 0.4 and 1.1 kilometers, 0.2 and 0.7 miles across. The combined length of all the lines is over 1,300 kilometers, 808 miles, and the group cover an area of about 50 square kilometers, 19 square miles. The lines are typically 10 to 15 centimeters, 4 to 6 inches deep. They were made by removing the top layer of reddish-brown iron oxide-coated pebbles to reveal a yellow-gray subsoil. The width of the lines varies considerably, but over half are slightly over 1/3 meter, just over 1 foot, wide. Some of the Nazca lines form shapes that are best seen from the air, 1,500 feet, 457 meters, though they are visible from the surrounding foothills and other high places. The shapes are usually made from one continuous line. The largest ones are about 370 meters, 1,200 feet long. Because of its isolation and the dry, windless, stable climate of the plateau, the lines have mostly been preserved naturally. Extremely rare changes in weather may temporarily alter the general designs. As of 2012, the lines are said to have been deteriorating because of an influx of squatters inhabiting the lands. The figures vary in complexity. Hundreds are simple lines and geometric shapes, more than 70 are zoomorphic designs of animals, such as a hummingbird, spider, fish, llama, jaguar, monkey, lizard, dog, and a human. Other shapes include trees and flowers. Scholars differ in interpreting the purpose of the designs, but in general, they ascribe a religious significance to them. They were designated as a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 1994. The high arid plateau stretches more than 80 kilometers, 50 miles, between the towns of Nazca and Palpa on the Pampas de Jumana, approximately 400 kilometers, 250 miles, south of Lima, roughly matching the main Peruanas, Panamericana Sur. The main concentration is in a 10 by 4 kilometers, 6 miles by 2 miles, rectangle, south of San Miguel de la Pascana hamlet. In this area, the most notable geoglyphs are visible. Although some local geoglyphs resemble Peruvian motifs, scholars believe the Nazca lines were created by the Nazca culture. The first published mention of the Nazca lines was by Pedro Cesar de Leon in his book of 1553, and he mistook them for trail markers. In 1586, Luis Monzon reported having seen ancient ruins in Peru, including the remains of roads. Although the lines were partially visible from the nearby hills, the first to report them were Peruvian military and civilian pilots